That stage cleaned up and everything just as it was. Get the bloodstains off their duds. You gotta look like the real McCoy, Johnny, when you ride into Culver City. I'll see you there.
Don't you worry.
Thank you.
All right, soldiers, get the box unloaded. Let's get it into the bank and out of the way.
Information. Somehow they found out which date was scheduled. The bullion stage they ambushed early that morning was also headed for Culver. They killed the escort driver and shotgun. Then they rode into the city and the rest was easy. As the shipment was supposed to arrive that day, nobody suspected a thing. Once in the bank, they quietly murdered the staff.
And took their places.
Right. But where the hell did they get their information?
I don't know for sure. But I do know this, Colonel. That plan has the stink of one of two authors. Maybe I recognize his signature.
I was hoping that might be the case. I chose you for this, Captain Norton, because on a job of this nature, I need someone who's familiar with these bandits and their working methods. Bring that bullion back in and wipe out those vermin if you can. The men of the 8th Cavalry are at your disposal, Captain. As many as you want.
I want just one man. Hunter.
Hunter? But you're the one who arrested him 2 months ago for robbery and desertion. El Chaleco.
That's right, sir. The Mexicans gave him that name for the fancy gold vest he wears everywhere. He probably doesn't take it off even when he bathes.
It'd be like trusting a rattlesnake. The moment your back was to him, he'd kill you. And apart from that, he's sentenced to hang tomorrow.
Sure, but it's not yet tomorrow, Colonel. If you want me to get that gold back, then he's the man I want.
Well, I'm sorry, Captain, but I'm not in a position to revoke the official sentence handed down at a court-martial.
Thank you. Good morning. Sleeping in?
You must figure that a real funny remark, Captain Norton.
I'm sure you'll give the Army a fine swinging death. Tell me, have you made your peace with God? Are you well prepared for death? Are you...
Norton! You go to hell!
I think you'll get there before me. You've already got a head start. I'll say one thing about the Army. They sure build beautiful scaffolds. This will be a real credit to your corpse.
Listen, you. Just because you're the one put me away, the hero responsible for the noose I'll wear tomorrow. Do you have to play games? Can't you leave me at peace now?
It'll be a pleasure to watch when they hang such a piece of scum.
We'll meet in hell, you bastard, Norton.
We'll meet before that, Chaleco.
Stuck in a closed position, Colonel, sir.
The door stuck?
Yes, sir. The men can't get in.
Well, break it down, then.
You heard the Colonel.
Hey, you guys, break the door down.
I assure you they won't get far, Colonel. I myself will head the search.
Break that door down.
Thank you.
Are you going to feed me?
No, you can feed yourself. First, we'll have a little talk.
Yeah. That's a good idea. You might explain just why you've spent over 2 years fitting a rope around my neck, just to save me.
It's simple. I need you. I'm looking for a guy who stole $50,000 that belongs to the Army. You know all the outlaws, so I want you to help me. If you help to recover the gold, it might save your neck. Otherwise...
Otherwise what?
I'll take you back. And you can finish that ceremony you started.
There's one thing I don't get, Norton. That plan of yours was pretty sharp, but why did you wait till this morning?
We couldn't annul the decision of the court-martial, and there was no way to suspend the sentence.
Hmm. And how do you know when you're not looking? I will put a couple of bullets through you.
Well, I guess I'll just have to take your word. As a gentleman.
The coffee fresh still?
Cordero! Cordero! Zacatecas has news for you of great importance.
Importance? Speak.
I am sorry to disturb you, senor, but I saw a covered wagon with many soldiers in escort, and I believed it was muy importante because it was very heavy and well guarded, and I thought that if I told the great Señor Cordera, being as how he is such a great patron, that I, his humble servant, might be getting...
Enough trouble. Where did you see it?
Señor Patron, I saw the wagon at Yellow Pass 3 days ago on the road to Culver City.
Going to Culver? You made sure of that?
Si, Señor Cordero. I followed the wagon to Culver. They unloaded two very heavy boxes and carried them into the bank.
There were others with you?
No, senor, I was alone. I came right away here without speaking of it to anyone else.
Gracias, amigo. Now we must make certain that our secret is kept between us. Now. Muchachos, there is gold waiting for us in the Culver City Bank.
Hold on a minute, Norton. My horse has gone lame on me.
Well, it's not far now. Come on, get up. He'll walk. Waste your energy. I hate to tell you this, Chaleco, but the chamber's empty.
And I hate to tell you, there was a bullet I just fired in the air. Now get out.
Ah!
thing I could do is kill you, Norton. But I'm alive because of you. So now we're even. See you in church.
The man we're after is Billy Gunn.
Mine, thanks.
Thank you. I'd swear on the Bible it was Billy Gunn did that first job. In fact, I owe this, and this to him and his bunch of murderers.
And the leg?
Cordero, he and his coyotes tried this morning, but we'd hidden all the gold, and when they got here, we were waiting for them.
Anybody follow Billy?
Yeah, apparently they headed through the Yaqui Pass. Trouble is, the darn trail splits after that. Sorry, gents, I'm afraid that's mighty slim pickings, though you might have a couple of words with old Jim Double Whiskey. I understand he was around those parts that day.
Where do we find this Jim Double Whiskey?
You shouldn't have no trouble, mister. If he ain't in that saloon, that means he's dead.
Hey, let me through. Let me in there.
Talk to Jim Double Whiskey.
Sure, I'll get him, mister.
You want to see me?
Where's Billy Gunn?
Well, how should I?
If he tells us, he gets a whole bottle of whiskey. Or else we're just going to have to beat him up.
Looks like Double Whiskey was right. They rode over the pass and up towards Little Canyon.
The wagon that left these tracks was heavy. All right, next one. You. Did you enjoy yourself?
Hey, it's your turn, Jed.
Yeah, but first it takes three drinks, huh? Hey, come on, Chiquita. Give us a little dance.
That's it, Jed.
One. Yee-haw.
Two.
Three.
All
right.
Sam, you gotta drink 15 glasses.
Come on, drink. Come on, drink.
Come on, Dave.
Yeah.
that's enough. The party's over. We're leaving. Load your gold in the wagon. And be quick about it. Go on. Start loading.
Things, they must have laid over somewhere for a few days. The tracks are fresh now and heading straight for Mexico. And that means they got to pass through a little canyon to get to the river.
How many hours in front of us are they now?
Not more than 3 or 4, I'd say. And with that heavy wagon, they're traveling easy.
The right place to wait is Little Canyon. We got to get there first.
Well, let's ride.
Let's ambush him in the canyon.
Yeah.
You go over there. I'll stay here. There's cover on both sides. That's good.
What are these two damn gringos doing here?
Don't shoot, muchachos. And we must not let them fire.
No!
Thank you.
the dogs over here. Experience great suffering for that.
You're gonna be real sorry. You'll get bad luck wearing that. And God help you if it's dirty when I catch up with you.
Neither of you will be doing any catching up, gringos malditos. You will just lie there till something comes along to drink the milk. Vamos, muchachos.
We'd never make it. There's too much damn water.
Yeah. Well, we'll have to go upriver about 10 miles and wait over in that abandoned mine. There'll be no more rain now. Water will go down soon enough. Stick behind the wagon and wipe out our tracks.
Yeah!
you're a pretty good shot.
Yeah, lucky for you, stranger.
By the look of things, it's somebody don't like you too much.
That ain't surprising in this territory. It's full of snakes. No-legged and two-legged kinds. You were darn lucky we came by. No fun lying out here in your long johns.
Yeah. Captain, these fellas already done us a favor, right? Can't ask them for more than that.
Mm-hmm.
Water's much too deep. They'd never have gotten a wagon through that. There's another crossing point at Golden Pass. That's about 2 hours' ride upstream.
That territory's patrolled by the army, Chaleco. He's likely to hit trouble there.
No, he's probably holed up in the old abandoned mine that I used to use myself for emergencies.
I get the feeling you're pushing for a promotion. Come on, General, let's go to that mine.
It's not that easy. We wouldn't stand a chance, just the two of us. It's like a fortress down there.
With two of us, you're right. What about 40?
Where are we gonna find 40 men?
Our friend Cordero. It's an idea.
Captain, you're mad. The whole thing's plain crazy.
Where do we find Cordero?
In San Pedro. That's his village.
All right, lead the way.
I might just as well have got my neck stretched.
Chaleco. Don't you want your vest back?
Hmm.
The devil refused to come and get you. This time I leave nothing to chance. And when you arrive in hell, say I sent you.
You're making a mistake, a bad one.
We didn't come here to get killed. We came to talk.
You want to speak to me?
Hmm?
You arrive here in San Pedro, you murder seven of my men, then pretend that you want to speak to me? You hear that? They want to speak to me.
If seven of your men are dead, they couldn't have been worth anything. What we came to say is worth a great deal more.
A couple of $100,000.
In gold.
You are a lying dog, gringo.
Take your filthy hands off of me.
Jose!
Speak, gringo, and quickly.
Just a minute. Hey, you. Real elegant.
Cordero, we know where to find Billy Gunn, and he's got the gold. You've got plenty of men, so we get it together. Then we split 50-50.
Bueno. Bueno.
Over here are the San Muerto Mountains. And right here, there's an abandoned mine.
You can find the mine, huh?
Yeah, no problem there. The gold is inside. All you gotta do is cover the entrance. That way you can shoot up his men as they break out.
Well, muchachos, what are we waiting for?
Don't be impulsive.
What means impulsive?
A fast thinker. The mine has a complex of tunnels which lead to another way out. Now, if we attack the main entrance, then Billy Gunn will disappear out through the other entrance into the hills.
As you say, I'm a fast thinker. I put some men at the other entrance and wait.
And where are you going to look for it? You got miles and miles of twisting, complicated tunnels leading through the hills every which way.
You needn't let it worry you. We'll find out where it is.
Somebody has to get inside the mine and follow the passages through to the other entrance. You can leave that side of it to me. Get into position tonight. The explosion's the signal to attack. And remember this. Billy Gunn is mine.
He is very sure of himself.
That's right. Billy Gunn is his brother.
Frank, you take the next watch in an hour.
Gringo, vamos.
here, Frank. Your deal.
Hey, Ned. Ned, wake up.
We're getting out of here before sunup. I want you two to ride point as far as the river.
Sure thing.
Cards.
I could kill you if I wanted, but I'm not here for you or for her. I'm here for the gold.
That gold's mine.
But you'd have to give some of it to your men.
There's enough for all of us.
Not now, there ain't. Now, mine is surrounded, Billy Gunn. By Cordero's Mexicans. You and your boys will never get out of here. You've got but one chance. Put yourself completely into my hands. Throw in with me, and we'll get out with the bullion. Then, split the gold, little brother. Right down the middle. All right?
Could be you're just trying to bluff, Chaleco.
Yeah? You mean you don't trust the word of your brother? Well, you're wrong.
Thank you.
Get a move on. The whole lot's gonna go in a minute. Get it out.
Hijos de putos. I will make them beg for death. Vamos!
What do you suggest now, Ted? One of us had better go and find a mule or pack horse.
Don't worry about it, Billy. This is as far as you're going.
He took my gun.
They'd make too much noise, anyhow. You used to be pretty good with a knife.
Thank you.
Peter. Why?
I did not hear from you no more of your letters. I began to think you must be dead. He kept telling me you were, and he forced me to stay with him. I prayed that you would come.
Who was she?
It doesn't matter now.
Problem, Chaleco. This stuff weighs a ton, and we don't have enough horses.
Gringos, do not worry about the gold. Here are plenty of horses.
There's federal troops all over this area. It'd be safer to travel at night.
They're thinking to me, gringo. I make the decisions here. We rest in San Rafael and cross the border at night. You can make your own decision when we are in Mexico.
Cordero, a platoon of soldiers are following our tracks. They are now about 4 miles behind us.
Muy bien. We will give them a warm welcome. Appreciate my little game, I see. You perform like the real professionals. I will pay you, gringos, with one quick bullet. The bullet will be for only one of you. The other will hang slowly. Billy Gunn, now you will see what happens to gringos who cross Cordero. The problem is one maybe that could arise again in the future, should I find you've been lying, amigo. So take warning before it is too late. I think as you are the heaviest...
I will be back later to finish this. Cut them down and tie them to the post. Vamos!
Thank you.
time you will really die. Oh, I've made mistakes. But no more gringos. My friends, you were simply lucky before. But your luck, she's run out. Adios, amigos.
Of the United States Army, you are now under arrest.
Colonel, sir, I've caught the two men I was after. Captain Norton and Chaleco. I've placed them under arrest.
The gold's on the mules, Colonel. Mission completed.
Thank you, Norton. I'll be putting in for your promotion today.
Thank you.